at my house today because Gio is due any second now. And because of that, I have to be on standby 24/7 because at any given moment, her water can break and I have to rush her to the hospital. So pretty much for this week and possibly even the next week or two, I have to pretty much stick onto her, constantly in view with her 24/7. So a Breaking Bad situation doesn't happen. If you watch Breaking Bad, you know what I'm talking about. It's when Walter White gets the deal of his lifetime, but then his wife gets into labor and he's like, wait, should I deal drugs and make $500,000 or should I, whatever. I don't want that to happen. I want to be where my wife is, where my baby is. So I'm training at home for the next couple of weeks. So I have a home gym because after the baby comes out, I'm going to be a full-time daddy. And during the first month, everyone's been telling me that's when it's the hardest because the baby needs you literally every 30 minutes, every hour. So I wanted to be able to balance all the things that I'm still doing while still being a father. So I have the most boiled down minimum version of Barbell Brigade that I can have and keeping only the necessities. So I can squat, bench, and deadlift here. I have cables to do accessories. I can do curls, overhead press. I even have a punching bag that I took down. I use that for cardio, and I even have a couple of dumbbells. So this is pretty much the most basic minimum gym setup that you need to be an effective powerlifter and bodybuilder. All the other stuff I wish I had at Barbell, like cable crossover, reverse hyper, all that cool stuff, and more importantly, my friends and the awesome gym atmosphere. But you know, I gotta be a daddy, so I gotta do what I can. I'm not gonna stop training at Barbell when the baby comes out. I think once the baby comes out, my number one responsibility is being a father. So I'm gonna be as best of a daddy as I can. Once I feel that Gio can handle being a mommy, or if we can trade off back and forth, then both me and Gio might be able to alternate who gets to go back to Barbell, because number one, that's our gym. So we love being there, we love our staff. But number two, we have to balance being a mommy and a daddy. The day that I actually can't wait for, though, is the day that our little baby, once he has all his immunity shots, I can bring him to Barbell, and that'll be awesome. Because I always see, like my buddy Charlie, who works for Super Training, he always brings his baby Miles to the gym all the time. And so the baby's just there listening to all the weights clanking and stuff and just smiling. And I'm like, man, that's so awesome. And the baby's like crawling around on the floor, building up immunity already. But most importantly, before all that happens, the baby has to get its shot. So I would love for our baby to be a gym baby and grow up in the gym and just love fitness from the start, but one step at a time. So it's really important for me to still be an athlete, even though I'm a soon to be father. I think it's really important to not shut down one aspect of your life when you have a new pursuit. I think being a well-rounded human being is about trying to experience everything that you can and still being able to achieve all your goals. And all the people that I look up to, they're really good at a lot of things, you know? Like for example, one of my idols is Richard Branson. And not only is he a mogul in the business realm, he also swims around his island every single day, and I think like a mile or two. So that's someone that I really look up to. So for me, I'd rather find ways to compromise and find ways to be able to accomplish everything rather than to shut things down. So at the end of the year in December, I still have a meet that I want to prep for, and I don't want my new baby to be the reason why I'm not gonna do it. I'm still dedicated on doing it, and I actually start my meet prep this week. And I know as people's lives get tough, it becomes harder and harder to do more things and accomplish goals. And that's the reality of it, you know? You know, there are people that are single moms, or there are people that don't have parents, or there are people that have a bunch of kids when they're 15 or 16 and they have all these responsibilities now. But I think when you're still able to accomplish your goals in spite of all this adversity, that's how you come out being a stronger person. And that's why we lift anyways, right? Like, we lift to become physically stronger, but what we're ultimately trying to do is be mentally stronger. So if you can find a way to still accomplish all your goals, I think that's the ultimate human experience.